Good evening, everyone.
Wow, that really does work. I'll stand behind.
So great to have you here this evening and have you at home watching as well. I need to remind you, just in case of emergency, to use the exits next to you or behind you and proceed quickly and quietly. These guys will go off stage and meet you outside if need be. I would ask that you silence any sort of electronic device that you have so that we don't have any extra sounds going on tonight. And with that, we're going to get started with Commando March.
Because all of these soloists that you're going to hear tonight are fantastic.
But also, I would just like to say this is one heck of a senior band class. So we're going to do this officially in a moment, but just so you see the percentage of what is going to happen after a few weeks, if you're a senior, stand up, please, or wave if you're in the back row in the percussion section. Yeah. So it's a good chunk. Thanks, seniors. Due to the outstanding musicianship and teamwork and leadership of those seniors and all the students here on stage, we get to be here tonight. It's hard to believe for me that less than 2 months ago, we were still rehearsing in separate cohorts at a feat of 12 feet apart from one another. It's not that long ago. And now these guys are gonna put on 2 performances in less than a week, and the seniors will get 3. And some of them 4, because they had the jazz concert on Wednesday. So it's amazing what these guys are doing, and the dedication and effort of every single person in this group is appreciated, and I think you'll be really proud of them. Our first soloist this evening has shown a tremendous passion for music since day one. I don't think it was just day one of high school. I think maybe day one of flute period, or maybe just day one of life. Whether it's jamming out with the pep band, playing various percussion instruments for pit or for jazz, playing piano, or playing the flute, which you'll hear tonight, the passion is clear. It has been my joy to watch her musicianship grow these past 4 years and to experience the true love of music that she demonstrates every day. Please welcome Tania Roser to the stage.
Thank you.
would say that for the first couple years of high school, maybe, I didn't really have too much opportunity to really get to know our next soloist. She seemed focused and quiet, always prepared, very conscientious, a little reserved. Little did I know, shortly after that, she would be racing down the hallway in my office rolly chair and asking me if she could hide in a band locker. Little did I know. Guess my first impression might have been a little off. But truth be told, she is all of those things I mentioned earlier, except for maybe the quiet part. And it has been my pleasure to work with her these past several years. Please welcome Maya Chaikin.
Thank you.
The next piece will actually feature two of our seniors in a unique situation where these two were such good friends and so supportive of each other that they decided to share the same concerto. As they would tell you, I was a little hesitant of how it would work at first, but I should have known that these two would make it work really well. They both work extremely hard at music, but I'm pretty sure it extends to everything they do. For instance, this year with Kate, up here, too, I've heard a little, some stories about the Vest family hockey games. They might get a little intense, so I'm pretty sure Kelsey definitely goes after everything. And Nina, though she presents herself on the quiet side, was an awesome member of Pep Band, which whose primary job is to yell. And we play, too, but she definitely has some enthusiasm in there as well. I'm so proud of both of these musicians, as neither one has ever, ever stopped working and pushing themselves. Please welcome Kelsey Vest and Nina Zhang. So our final soloist of the first half belongs to the section that seems to have some sort of competition about who can play the loudest. We had an after-school rehearsal last week. We were rehearsing one of the pieces for next Wednesday. And I honestly think if it were not our distanced COVID times, that Gerard might have actually moved the hair of the person in front of him. But because we had a little 9 feet distance, it was a little safer, but it was really pretty energetic. But I believe it is with that same enthusiasm and energy that this young man approaches everything in life. Go for it, put everything in you have, and he's such a positive force and kind person. Though he might play loudly, I'm pretty sure he's about as gentle as they come. Please welcome Gerard McCrohan. At this point, we're just going to take a quick 10-minute intermission. If you need to use the restroom, feel free to get up and do so. If not, if you want to just hang out in here, stand up and stretch, we'll be back shortly. Thanks.
Before we bring our next soloist to the stage,
I want to take just a moment to thank our AV guys, Jason McKay and Joe Pichato, for all the fantastic and wonderful things that they always do for us, most especially this year, whether it was the docu-concert that they did for us at the beginning of the year, or the live streams, or finding a mic to do this, or helping us Zoom this and that and everything else. They made what we do possible this year. And they won't be happy that I did this. But let's please show them how much we all really appreciate the time and effort that they put in. So this next soloist and I have a lot in common. We both love animals. We chat about, you know, our various pets and how cuddly or not cuddly they are. We both play the saxophone, both love music. We're both fantastic vocalists. Okay, do you notice they're the ones that laughed? maybe not, but at least she is. She's one of the most versatile, expressive, and humble musicians I've worked with. She's won awards and honors, but you wouldn't know it by talking to her or because she shows any sort of ego. Instead, she prefers to work hard, prepare well, and thus perform well, while being the best team member anyone could ask for. Please welcome Sadie Fridley to the stage with her good friend, Pablo the Saxophone.
Thank you.
Our final soloist this evening has been a four-year member of Wind Ensemble and perhaps has some of the greatest time management skills I've ever seen. Perhaps it is just because she can run further and faster than the rest of us. But somehow the amount of stuff she's good at just continues to grow. Again, though, despite her success in any venue, you just might not realize it. Now, I'm not sure what her parents would say about what she says at home. I'll have to investigate. But I don't think she has ever, and I mean ever, because I really thought about it, complained to me about anything. She just went with the flow of everything. And her leadership and work ethic in Wind Ensemble and Jazz Ensemble these last several years has made a tremendous impact on me, her colleagues, and I'm sure audiences alike. Please welcome Grace Karcher as our final soloist.
Thank you.